So today we are going to discuss about the edge computing and IoT. And also in the second part, we are going to take up the wearable technology trends in the wearable technologies. So now the first question arises is that because there are different kinds of terminologies are coming. As we see, starting from the simple computing, fog computing, cloud computing, information technology, IoT, and also the different variants of IoT is also coming up. So question is that what is an edge computing and why it is being clubbed with the IoT? So all you are aware of that we are living in a golden era where computing is everywhere. Whether you talk about any of the area, whether we talk about agri electronics, whether we talk about medical devices, whether we talked about the even personal care devices, any kind of devices, computing playing a very important role. Why? Because there is a lot of technological developments are going on, starting from the electronics, machine intelligence, and also the different algorithm in terms of a detection, recognition, identification. So that can be embedded and a technology can be formed. Because of the superior in the software technologies are available, there are different powerful hardwares also available, miniaturization form. And important thing is a communication, because you are aware of that nowadays lot of communication is being taken place. So because of the all this availability of different components, we can devise, we can design a technology for the mankind. We can devise the technology for the strategic application. We can devise the application for the variety of the users. So if you will see the trend, for example, this PCs, smartphone, tablets, and you have seen nowadays smartphone is increasing. The trend of using of a smartphone, so technologies around smartphone is increasing. You can see there are cumulative 14% increase in there compared to the previous years. So it means the people want a miniaturized form, more intelligent, and everybody demands like intelligent cameras, other software, other feature tracking. So people are demanding more power, more feature in the cameras. And you can see the smartphone which was available 5 years before and now what kind of different things are available. And there are future challenges also, because when we are saying the edge computing, when we talk about the IoT, when we talk about the technologies, there are a lot of communication challenges also there. Because when we are saying lot of devices need to be connected, so you can see, and also we do not want to transfer only the process data, we also want to transfer the raw data. It means we required a lot of bandwidth of the device, fast communication. So you can see what in real time also, because real time communication is an important thing when one device is transferring the data, process data, as well as raw data as well in two stream. Normally what is happening, sometimes people are transferring the process data, but people are demanding a two stream parallel at a time when raw data as well as a process data is being transferred. So you can see there are many devices to be covered. Delay is to be minimized. Reliability of the network should be more, and accessibility wherever there should not be a geographical restriction and time restriction wherever, whenever, right? So it should be available. And another thing is a speed, because we want the data should be available at the constant. It should not be delayed. Because why it should not be delayed? When we talked about the real-time application, and we are also taking about the critical technologies. So there should not be delay in transferring of the data, in computation of the features, in designing of detection algorithm. So all these should be seamless to be performed in a defined time. Because the we talk about the real-time system, the definition itself saying that logical correctness is not only important, but the timing correctness is also important. If the task is performed but has not performed at the defined time, it is considered as a failure of the system. That is why time is also an important thing. And therefore, all these society, you can talk, it is virtual reality office, traffics are there, right? Emergency networks are there, natural disasters are there. So all these technology required the real time and a fast communication. These are the really great challenge in front of us. And if we will see the Google search, previously the people were talking about the wireless sensor network. Now people are searching more for the Internet of Things. Wherever we are going, technology solution we are taking care. So Internet of Things is being connected. Because of the Internet of the Things, we are able to connect the ordinary user, we are able to connect the ordinary persons and reach within the society. Therefore, it is having lot of advantage of the IoT. So question comes, what is IoT? So we talked about Internet of Things. So interconnecting of physical devices. When we are saying physical devices, there will be a different kind of sensors will be there. Like embedded with electronics, there will be a software, and also the network connectivity that enables to collect and exchange the data. When we are saying collection of a data, because always a sensor is acquiring certain amount of data for a particular quantity. For example, it can be temperature, it can be accelerometer. Accelerometer is giving you acceleration, velocity, maybe strain. So depending upon what kind of application you are designing, what kind of parameter is required, so sensor will be used. There can be a single sensor, there can be a multiple sensor. So depending upon how much sensor we are taking care, then all are connected in form of a network and they are exchanging the different kind of data. So if true sense we want to define, then the IoT can be defined as it should have identities, physical attributes, and virtual personalities. Physical attributes means, for example, if you are connected over a network, then each and every node is having its own identity. From where the sensor picked up the signal. For example, you are having a natural disaster kind of a thing, right? For example, a earthquake detection. So which network has detected, which sensor has detected? So you should know what is the location. Similarly, for example, other body area network. So which network is giving which signal? And another thing is that we are using an intelligent interface. Intelligent interface, you are aware of that. Previously, it was a direct communication. Now touch type of communication interface is also there. And you are also aware of Siri. When we are in an Apple phone, when we talk, then automatically interfaces are there. And these intelligent interface not only restricted to a touch kind of thing, not only restricted to the voice, but nowadays we are going to a brain computer interface where there will be a signal in the brain that will be translated, because you are aware of that there are different kind of disabilities are there. And for example, a wheelchair is there. So wheelchairs, sometimes people may not be comfortable or not having proper sense to drive it through their hands. It can be by the click of the eyes as well, and movement of the eyes left or right. Similarly, cognitive things, when we are thinking that it should move forward, that is why brain computer interface. Even the neck movement, muscle is also moving. So now you can see with the availability of an intelligent interface, we can also give the technology for the disabled, which is a need of the hour, because people may not have the proper things. So whatever, similarly, for example, a blind person is there. Blind person cannot see. So how he can operate from the mouse, how he can operate from the touch kind of thing, but he can speak. So like that, according to the application, we are deciding the different kind of interface and their intelligence vary. Another thing are that they are seamlessly integrated. Integrated means that we are forming a network around the sensor, around the systems for a particular application. And whenever there is an on and off, because sometimes they may go off. So automatically network should know, for example, if you are moving with a mobile phone from one state to another state, you are going to connect and disconnect, because signal is automatically available, but may not be from a one particular network, but you are switching to the another network. Similarly, if you are moving from another state to another state, so like that, there will be a connectivity and disconnectivity. Similarly, if a network is there, you can connect n number of more devices. You can disconnect depending upon your requirement. And another thing is that if a system is going to give you an information network, because ultimately, what is the purpose of the network? Because network has to do certain kind of thing. And one more thing, if anything you want to discuss, you can raise a question, because otherwise it will be one way. Anything you want to discuss with me, it can be online, we can discuss. So information network means what kind of information we are retrieving from the network or expecting. For example, if it is an early warning system, so our target is that whenever any event is there, before that it should give the signal, right? For example, there can be a flood monitoring system, there can be an earthquake monitoring system, there can be a landslide monitoring system. Like that, there can be environmental pollution monitoring system. So what information we are deriving so that a user can use that? Similarly, for the agro application, for example, we are taking care of the farms, whether they are having good pH value or not, whether they will give us a good yield or not. So we are having a network which is telling which land is more fertile, right? Similarly, we can also tell to the farmer that your land is best for these kinds of crop. So that kind of information network is required. Similarly, for example, medical network, there can be a body sensing network. So we are able to find out the disease. We are able to find out the blood pressure. That kind of network is there. Another thing is self-configuring, means like if we are moving one to another, so automatically addition and deletion should be identified by the central recording station. And we are also using the standard and interoperable communication protocol. Why this is required? Because when we are talking about a network scattered all way, geographical domain, if they are not following the standards, then we will not be able to communicate properly. We will not aware of the what kind of data has been derived. And if we are processing, for example, eight different networks are there, eight different nodes are there, all are giving the data, but they are giving in a different format, then how we are going to process it? They should be of the same sampling rate. They should be defined, for example, whether we are storing in terms of a voltage, whether we are storing in terms of a hexadecimal value, right? So, or a count value, how we are storing our data. Similarly, header information, whether they are at the top, how much number of bytes are there. If, for example, three channels are there, whether complete one channel at one time, then second channel, then three channel, or byte by byte. For example, first channel, second channel, third channel, then first, second, third. Like that, if they are following the standard one, then we are able to process and we can write algorithm. Even the algorithm can be written by the different entity. For example, eight different nodes is being taken care by the different departments or different organization. Then also we can take care about their format. We can process them in a real time. So that is why this is very important. And another thing is that there are physical and virtual thing. Thing is very important. Thing means what? Thing mean the device. Thing mean the sensor. We can see this. The thing word is related to whether what quantity we want to derive. For example, temperature, pressure, position, weight. Take example. For example, we want to know the structural health monitoring. The building is there and we want to know the health of a building. How we can know the health of a building? It can be the vibration. It can be the temperature of a concrete. It can be the pressure. So like that, all the sensing modality is to be connected. And another question comes, how many number of sensors are required? At which beam it is required, which layer it is required? For example, we talk about a 5-floor building. So each floor is having different kind of sensors. And each sensor is giving you data. There will be n number of channel. All are coming together and combined, how mathematical model we can derive. And we can say this building is safe or unsafe. And also we are able to find out whether there is a damage is there or not in the first question is that whether damage is there or not. If, for example, damage is there, then another problem comes to locate the damage, identification of damage and location of a damage so that a retrofitting can also be taken place. This is a simple example. Another example, for example, there is a critical installation. For example, take any building. So, for example, take any building where you want no intruder should be after 5 o'clock. Suppose a person is entering, how you are going to detect a presence of a person? First thing is that you want to detect the presence of a person. Then you want to locate the presence of a person where it is. So, first question is that, or first solution is that, simple put the camera and camera will give you a presence of a person or not. There may be n number of cameras, but the question again, because when we are talking about the simple technology, seems to be solved by the simple camera. But take care of 24/7. Will it work in night? Then you can say we can have an IR camera, right? But if IR camera is there, you are aware of that a camera life is very limited because lens, and also it is a power hungry. Because it is consuming a lot of power. So what you will do, if you will keep it always on, then you can understand if, for example, 10 camera you are having, how much power consumption is there. Suppose power is off, then your network will be failure. Then what is the extra solution? So what we can do, we can note from the ground sensors, right? And ground sensor, if some energy, because whenever there will be a footstep, when a person is moving, it means some vibration pattern will be and sound wave will be generated. And that sound wave can be picked up in form of an energy. And our sensor can detect its presence, because when nobody is there, there will be a noise level only. But whenever a signal comes, then it automatically detects the presence of an intruder. And then by the real-time processing from the frequency pattern, we can identify, yes, the presence of a some object you have detected, right? And also you can pinpoint if array of a sensors are there, whether it is coming from left side or right side, because where energy is more, right? And if it is moving, then from 1 to 10 sensors are there. If it is moving 1 to 10 direction, then we can identify how he is moving. We can also find out the velocity, because after interval, how its energy is being changing. Then we want to authenticate, yes, it is because of the human being only. Then we can switch on our camera. So now I am talking about a technology with a single identity, that is ground sensor. And I am also talking about the technology with the two modality. One is a ground sensor, another is a camera. But camera is not active all the time. Ground sensor, because it do not require any power. So it is active always. But when it has detected something, then we are switching it on camera. Now you can see, for example, in a 1 week, if a person enter only once, now your camera will be on only once as compared to 24/7. But your technology is working 24/7 because of the ground sensor. And that will be more authentic as well, because sometimes camera may fail. Right, but ground sensor will be the array of sensor. If one fail, another will detect, and no power is there, and cost effective also, because a IR camera, you can understand, cost effective, and also the processing. For example, a IR camera is working on a 60 hertz frame rate, right? So 60 frame you are having 1 second. If you are having 5 camera, 300 frames in a 1 second. And now you can see hardware processing, even your software processing detection algorithm, right? So 300 frame to be processed in a 1 second. And when your system will give presence of a person, person can move. So again, there is a complexity. So you have to see how much frame is enough, which frame will be enough, right? Because normally 60, 120 hertz, these kinds of frame rates are available. But in case of a ground sensor, for example, it is working at the rate of 100 sample rate. And you are aware of that. What is the relation between how we are fixing the sampling rate? depending upon the sampling rate, Shannon theorem and Nyquist theorem, that what is the expected bandwidth, maximum bandwidth, and we are making double of the frequency. For example, in case of a footstep, it may be near about 10 to 20 hertz. Now you can see 100 hertz will be appropriate for us. Similarly, for example, temperature need not to take 100 times in a second, right? Because temperature is not changing in a second span. We can take even 10 minute. Like that, there will be a samples will be processed differently. That is why there are different kind of a system. One is a uniform rate, another is a multi-rate. Multi-rate system are that where the sensing modality is being processed at the different sampling rate. And you know how it is being processed? Do you know? I'm asking you, for example, multi-rate system is there. A single ADC, can we achieve a multi-rate with a single ADC? No, we cannot achieve. Because a single ADC, if there are 3 or 8 channel, all have to perform at this uniform rate. If for a multi-rate, we have to take care of the independent ADC for each entity. One ADC will work only on fixed sampling rate. So means if you are having 3 entity, you need 3 ADC separately. Then you can define. Otherwise, there will not be a multi-rate. So therefore, multi-rate and uni-rate, they are very important terminology when we are defining an intelligent network, right? Whether to go for a same. Another question comes, what is the resolution of an ADC? Whether 8-bit is appropriate for you, 12-bit, 16-bit, or 24-bit, right? Depending upon your signal, whether it is close to your noise, for example, footstep, then you should have 16-bit to 24-bit ADC. Right, temperature can be taken depending upon the resolution, how much resolutions, different intervals are there. If 8-bit is there, 2^8 will be there. If 24 will be there, 2^24. Another thing, what is the dB of the signal you are expecting? So these are the different scientific aspect. I am not going detail, but when you are designing these kinds of things, these are very important one. Because this is going to define your sampling rate. This is going to define your whether single-ended or differential. This is also telling the what kind of quantity you are going to store, because ultimately you are processing in a real time. For example, why it is important? See, 100 hertz is enough for you, and if you are making a, for example, 10k as a sampling rate, right? So you are wasting your bandwidth, right? Because 100 hertz will be more than enough for you. And sometime, for example, you have set the sampling rate as a 20 hertz. But 20 hertz, you are expecting the maximum bandwidth also 20 hertz. Then you are going to miss the signal. That is why these points are very important when you are designing any application, when you are designing your hardware, designing your software, when you are designing a technologies. Another thing, how much channel is required, whether single channel, three axis. Like for example, accelerometer, right? They come single also, they come a triaxial also. So whether there is a provision you have taken care, so thing mean the sensing modality you are going to apply. So another thing, IoT, because we talked about thing, now what ultimate we are doing from the IoT technology, there is a data, and data is being generated because data is a gold mine. The person who is having data, whenever any person is doing publishing something, then the question comes on the data, how you are acquiring the data. Because if you are having data and ground truth is also there, then you can check your technique, you can validate your technique, right? Sometime we are searching the online data. So if we are connecting the things together, then ultimately they are producing a data as per the design of experiment, as per the things you have set. For example, which camera you are using, which frame rate is there, how much duration of data is there, whether there is a background noise is there or not, whether there is an event is there or not, what kind of variability you have introduced. Whatever may be, whether it is a field operated related to agriculture, medical, disasters, right? Whatever, or structural health, whatever be the applications are there, how you are acquiring the data. Whether it is a single sensing, whether it is a multi-sensing, and also whether it is for the one location or it is a geographical spread location. Like, for example, pollution, whether it is for a particular sector or it is a particular city or you are having a particular region. And the complexity will increase, even the data will be there. So ultimate aim for the IoT is to producing a data, and this data can be raw data, this data can be processed data. So raw data means only whatever sensor is giving the data that has been stored. Processed data can be filtered data, right? You have applied the filter at the node level, that can be filtered. Another thing also, you might have computed some quantity, for example, statistical parameters. So that can be available. So depending upon you, what kind of data you want to store or you want to process from the raw data, right? There can be another quantity, there can be attributes. You might be aware of that, whichever field you belongs to. You are extracting certain features, vectors, right? Then you are storing. And that is very important. If you understand your data, then you can design a very good application. You can design a good detection technique. You can design a good classification tech. For example, a simple example, we taken an application where a man is entering to a building, right? And we are calling it as an event. A person has entered, so event happened. So now, intelligently, we want to know, discriminate between noise and event. Like, so you should have a lot of data for the noise. You should have a lot of data for the presence of a human being. When you will process the both, then you can design a automatic intelligent technique which will discriminate that this signal packet is belongs to a noise or this signal packet is belongs to a event. Similarly, it can be applied to the different applications. Another thing is a thing against a physical device, physical quantity, what parameter you are going to extract. And ultimately, the pupil, because the technology to whom you are making, if that is not been delivered, mean dissemination of the information. IoT means, for example, mobile network, right? For example, if you are entering to a particular city, can it tell you real-time air quality? Right, when you are entering from Chandigarh, for example, Chandigarh to Delhi, you are moving. Like, for example, message you are getting, okay, now this network, Idea network or Airtel network, you are getting some messages. Are you getting the messages that air quality in Delhi is this? Are you getting a message that traffic congestion is, if Google is there, it is telling you real time. So ultimately, the dissemination of an information, like for example, there may be a natural disaster, cyclone, right? There can be a rain. Whether automatically you are getting that message that the area you are approaching is having this kind of disaster. So that kind of thing is required because we are connecting to the people, right? So if people are not being connected, then our ultimate purpose is not solving. Now, for example, we are having a lot of technology for the farmers, right? So whether that is having proper reach, right? So that kind of thing is very important for the technology. This is also a technological gap where we need to connect the people, and people can be connected through mobile because most of the person are having mobile, right? There are areas where they can, for example, a person is going to a hospital, right? They are having their OPD date. Can it be alert? Your date is on this date, right? Similarly, for example, weather information. Similarly, for example, disaster information. Like that, automatically it is being updated. But it is only possible when the technological connectivity is there. Another thing is a process. Means you are extracting the information and presenting to the people what process is being involved. Whether that is offline, that is online, because sometimes online information is very crucial, right? So what kind of, and that process is purely engineering process. That processor is having a lot of innovations. How you are connecting, how data is being taken, a lot of innovations are involved. So that is very important. So what we are doing from the IoT, that we are taking data. Data is being generated from the thing, means sensors, physical attributes. And we are having a lot of process in between. process can be detection process, recognition process, classification process, right? Then dissemination routines may be there. And finally, we are connecting the user. And user can be connected by mobile. User can be connected by simple SMS. User can be connected by a alarm. User can be connected by giving an email. Or there can be a horn kind of situation, alarm kind of situation when we are talking about a building, right? So these kinds of things, IoT is providing you the complete solution up to data to the people level, all connectivity. So the next question comes to what are the elements of an IoT? Because IoT people are talking IoT, what are the attributes, what are the elements we talked about? For example, identification. Identification is very important. For example, you are having 10 sensors. One thing is that you are having 3 different kinds of sensor. Another thing, you are having 10 each. So it means 30 sensors you are having, right? And you are having a campus. So from where the data is being triggered or from where the true event is being detected, you should be aware of that. So there will be always ID associated with the sensors. Which sensor is giving which signal? Whether that sensor is giving correct signal or not, we should know their ID. It can be a building kind of a network. It can be a regional network. Say, for example, in Delhi, if I will have a 5 network at a different locations, one at a center, another at the 4 corner, so which sensor get triggered? The identification is there. And with the identification, we can resolve, we can process. Another thing is sensing. What quantity we are sensing? Like, for example, we discuss about the footstep. There can be pressure, there can be temperature. So what sensing? That is why question come, is single sensing or multi-sensing? Always, if you are going to authenticate, then multi-sensing is always appropriate. Because with the single sensing, there may be a failure rate. And now with the advancement of technology, people do not want to have the failure rate or false positive. People want to have an alarm. For example, take an example that a network is alerting for something. Take this example only. If a person entering to your campus, a alarm will be raised. Now suppose no person has entered and still you are getting an alarm. Then what will happen? Even if a person enter, you may not rely on the network. So now you can understand where the ruggedness is important, where your each and every routine is important, because we want to discriminate between noise and the event. Now it should be more rugged. Your technique, your hardware, all should be in such a way that it should not give you false alarm. And most of the person where the early warning alert system are there, people are working on the reducing of the false alarm. If your system is not giving even a single false alarm, most appropriate. They are having, because with single sensing, there may be false alarm. But with the two sensing, for example, we have taken two sensing. One is a ground sensor, another is a camera. Ground sensor may give you, for example, there may be energy generated because of the distance source. But our camera is authenticating the presence. So dual sensing is giving us a more confidence. If single sensing, for example, structural health is there, for example, pressure is there, that may lead to a, now we are having acceleration also. We are having stress also. We are having crack meter also. So change in the frequency also we are studying. So what I am saying, okay, whenever we want to establish a network or sensing, multi-sensing is giving you more authenticated result as compared to uni-sensing. And another thing is a communication, because nowadays we are not talking about the sensors available at a particular site. They are scattered network, distributive network. Then only, for example, a pollution network is there. We want to design for a city. Then from every sector, we want to know the things, right? Similarly, for example, agricultural land is there. There may be different varieties are there, right? There may be disasters. For example, a Delhi network, we want to complete fencing with the sensors. So they will be distributed at a different place. Now, how they are connected to a network? Network will be established when they are connected. So what are the possible ways of communication you are thinking? For example, there can be a LAN, right? There can be a GSM. You can have your SIM bill is there. You can put and connect a network, dial a network. There can be VSAT connectivity. And nowadays there are LoRa also there, right? So different kind of communication aspect can be connected to form a network. Because say if your network is failed, communication fails, then whether that information, which is very critical in nature, may reach to your, for example, a plant is there, right? A plant is having different sensors and it is said, for example, it is a juice plant. And we have established if temperature goes beyond 20 degree, then juice will be wastage. It will be contaminated because this is a standard we have fixed. And now because temperature you have detected is 22 degree, it is abnormal activity for our plant. And decision can be only taken by the control center control recorder. So how your data will be transferred and that network is failure. Now you can see the consequences of that. So that is why the communication channel, communication network should be available. And when there is a situation when you are having a lead time of a few seconds, then you cannot wait. You cannot afford to have a communication delay as well. So there are certain kinds of technology which is very crucial, also depending upon what kind of latency, what kind of error, what kind of bitrate delay is there. Because we want a 100% availability of network. Right? Otherwise, this is a simple example. There can be other example. Like for example, disasters are there, earthquake. They travel at a faster rate. Right? If it will not be informed. For example, a person who is entering to your campus and you are informing after 1 minute. 1 minute he might have crossed. Right? So processing time is very important. And it also the communication is very important because if it will not be informed at a right time, then complete, because we are talking about a real-time system, and real-time system means not only the logical correctness but also the timing correctness we have to take care. If task performed but not at a defined T, then it is a failure of the system. Take for example a missile, right? A missile is to be fired, right? A target is there and a missile has to fire. Even if launch, but it has not hit at a particular time, then it's a failure of the system. Then another thing is a computation, because it's there can be a simple instrument which is only measuring the quantity. It is a low cost. But another system which is having intelligence enough to process the signal, for example, brain computer interface. Now you can understand, it's not only a simple button we are pressing. Now our cognition is there, our brain is thinking, and that command is being converted and device is being operated. Say for example, wheelchair, it is moving forward and backward with our command, what we are thinking. And now you can think how to convert that cognition load into the signal and interface that will be of high cost. Therefore, computation power is important. That how much computationally rich you are making your system, that also define the hardware requirement. Because that cannot be simply by the, for example, you are having real-time image processing, 60 hertz signal we talked about, whether it is possible with the Raspberry Pi. No, you have to require a high end, right? You are having a multi-sensing. You are having, for example, 8 quantity measure. All are processed in real time. Now you can understand. Similarly, whether there will be a machine intelligence available at the device. If machine intelligence is available, then you can see there will be a lot of computation is required. So the cost, not only in terms of a money, but the cost in terms of a hardware, cost in terms of a software, and all combined timing is also in the cost. How much time it is taking for the computing to give you first result. That is very important. worst possible time, processing time, right? Sometime you are handling a file operation. Sometime you do not handling a file operation. With file operation, there will be more time. Without file operation, there will be less time. And there will be a situation when there will be high computation in a real-time situation. For example, we have taken an example when an intruder is trying to enter into a building. Now take the two situation. When there is no intruder, what it is doing, it is acquiring and processing the detection algorithm only. And it has not detected, so it is discarding continuously in a buffer. It is processing the data and detecting nobody is available. Now the second situation, when a person is available, so what it is doing, it is processing the data and informing, yes, I have detected the person. Now what extra computation node we are having? We are switching it on the camera, acquiring the image and processing the signal as well as the image. And once we have authenticated, now we are informing user also. We are giving alarm. We may giving the SMS to the mobile phone, right? So now you can see the computation load when no person is available and the computation load when a person is available and he is moving also towards a critical zone, right? And there can be a situation that in a single day, once you are making the GPS clock synchronization, do you know what is GPS clocks are available? Global positioning system, they are giving you UTC, universal time, right? Universal time and coordinated system is there. So you are also want to see the clock difference of your system and GPS. So you have set at 12 o'clock, at every 12 o'clock, it should check the difference in the time and set the time correction, right? Got it? This is what I'm saying your system is working on the GPS time. And because clock is always having some reduction in time, so we want to update our clock synchronized with GPS. So what we have set, at every 12 o'clock, our clock is being updated as we are taking the data from GPS, taking the clock data and checking whether there is a difference is there or not. And then we are updating. Now you see at 12 o'clock, our event is true. At 12 o'clock, we need to update the clock also. At the same time, when camera is also authenticated the presence, now we have to inform to the user also. Now you can see as compared to a situation when nobody is there and now see when everything is on. So your cognition load is increasing, your computation load is increasing. So now you have to see if you are designing a technology, what is the maximum possible in the time sequence, that what is the max at some particular T, how much computation load we are having on the net, our hardware. If you will not see, the hardware is not capable to handle that computation load, and it is a failure. Then it will hang, right? Because it varied accordingly. It is not uniform at a time. Another thing, for example, third scenario, when your sensor has detected the presence of a person, but your camera is not authenticating. If it is not authenticating, it means it is discarding, considering as a false alarm. Now, three scenario we have seen, but whether computational load is same in all the three scenario. One scenario when nobody is there, another scenario when there is a false alarm, which is not authenticated by the camera, and third one when all have detected the presence of a person. All these three cases, our computation load is different, right? Another thing is service. Service means if network is there, if it is not giving service to the user, means if it is not informing to the user, for example, pollution, I am having a lot of network, right? But I am having only data available with me. If it is not disseminated to the right person, right thing, it is a failure of the system. What for network will be there, right? Like for example, smart city we are calling. And with a smart city, we are expecting there will be a lot of things will be automatic, right? and people will get a lot of things alert on their mobile, right? A lot of expectations are there. What city is supposed to give a good services to the citizen if it is not being provided? So IoT services is a major element in IoT technology, that it is providing a particular services to the customer. And that services can be uniform to all, like for example, a temperature or a pollution, everybody required same thing. But there can be a customer specific requirement may be there, site specific requirement may be there. Like for example, the same example we have taken, the intruder in a building. We may want a log may also there, email also there, alarm also there, but some user may do not want that thing, right? So depending upon user to user, their requirement may vary. They may want to generate the report also. They want to store the data in a database also. So depending upon what is the user requirement, sometime we are customizing our technological solution. But main thing is same, only we are adding few features. And that is a cost effective in terms of a computation, in terms of a communication, in terms of a service. And the last thing is a semantics. Means how your data is being stored, how your data is being processed. Because for example, if data ADCs are there, it will be in form of voltage. If we are giving in form of voltage to the user, what it will understand? It will not understand. So we have to process the data and tell exactly, right, this is the situation. For example, if we are giving in terms of a quantity, it will not understand. Like 1.2 volt I have received from the acceleration. Acceleration is actually sensor is giving you the acceleration. So we have to convert into the meaningful form. We have to store data into the defined format so that we can retrieve, we can process again. Again, the header information. Because for example, 2 person working on the same project, 1 person is setting the sampling rate at 100 Hertz. Clear? Another person may set 200 Hertz and both data is available to us. How we will come to know it is 200 Hertz, it is 100 Hertz, right? Some person may acquire the data in single channel. Some person may acquire in 2 channels, some person in 3 channel. How we will come to know how many number of channels are there until unless it will be stored in a header information. So that is why standard syntax and semantics is also important. So the different kind of IoT elements, starting from the identification, each sensor should have some certain IoT. Sensing will be there, what quantity we are sensing, multi-sensing, uni-sensing, and communication is playing important role because of the acquiring the data and dissemination of the information. Computation load will be there, whether simple computation or a high end of a machine learning computation, what kind of services we are giving to the user and how data is being stored. They are the very important IoT elements in a technology. Then question comes that what are the characteristics of an IoT? We can see that there is an internet connectivity. Because of the internet connectivity, we are able to give the email. Right? Sometime, you know, web is also there, web page is there that is updated with the information. Like for example, weather information, right? IMD site, you can see when. So internet connectivity is also required, right? If internet connectivity will not be there, we cannot disseminate properly to the user. And unique identity, you can understand why it is important, uniqueness, right? If it is not on, then also we should know which network is off from the network. And ubiquity means there will be different kinds of sensor, if self-configuring kind of thing, whether you are moving from one place to the another place, its presence and detection should be aware of that. Sensing and actuation, sometimes we are sensing a parameter and automatically action we are taking. Say for example, lift. If we feeling this some abnormality, then we may switch off certain kind of critical facility. Like for example, nuclear plant is there. If some production is going on, nuclear radiations are there. So we can switch off during the abnormality because we cannot take care by the human intervention. It should be automatic because human intervention may take time, right? Say we have taken an example when juice is being produced, and 22 degrees and abnormal temperature for it. So automatically some preventive action should be taken. Right? Sensing and actuation, mean activate should be there. And interoperable interaction will be there, because there are different kind of situation where we are taking different kind of decisions because intelligence we are having. Self-configuring mean it should not be like that ki if you want to add more network, there will be restrictions. So automatically there will be addition and deletion of the thing. And programmability is very important aspect, because you are making a generalized technology and their user will vary. One particular user may be interested for a different kind of sensing. One user may be interested in the different kind of sampling rate, right? One user may be interested for a particular quantity. So we can program according to the requirement. An interconnection means there will be a peer-to-peer, there will be client-server, depending upon so many application, we are forming a network. So they are also the part of characteristics of the Internet of Things. So when we talk about Internet of Things, there are certain technologies involved in this, because Internet of Things is a total spectrum it is covering. Say, for example, sensor network, we discuss a lot, there will be a sensor network to generate thing, because Internet of Things means a sensor which is connected with the internet technologies. Another thing is an embedded system, because embedded system is processing the data. It is a part of the network. An embedded system power vary from which sensing to multi-sensing you are moving. Computation load also it is deciding, right? Whether we are talking about a ARM9 or FPGA kind of thing, even the more we are talking about. Another thing is a cloud computing, how data is being shared by the different enterprises, right? And then discovery services to be provided, system integration, finally all the things to be worked together seamlessly to give a particular parameters. Another thing is software. Software, you are, for example, detection algorithm, recognition algorithm, classification algorithm, right? There can be other thing, for example, information dissemination algorithm. Similarly, there can be operating system, right? So these vary. Communication we discuss. Nano electronics means the material level, because sometime in the second phase we will discuss about the wearable technology, flexible material, because of the nano electronics only it is possible. Sometime technology is oil repellent, for example, your surface is available for a mobile phone. If oil will come, automatically it will repel. So that technology is possible only because of nanotechnology. Standard, we discuss why it is essential to follow these standards for storing of data, and standard connectivity so that we can expand our network, right? We can store our network. Standard is always important. Another thing, knowledge aggregation. We are finally not only deriving the data, what we are also deriving the knowledge from it. What knowledge we are, because that knowledge will also used as a training of a network. For example, you are identifying the presence of a person. So if you will collect the data, and automatically it will auto train. And another thing, future internet, lot of device will be connected, and security is also a concern, because when you are talking about the critical facility like nuclear reactor, shutting down a nuclear reactor is a cost involved. So it should not be like that if people will intrude into the system and false generate the command, right? And if it is a public network is there, intentionally people has given a wrong command. So there will be crash kind of situation that should be avoided. So therefore, security protocol is also important for IoT when we are talking about the critical application or critical installation. So IoT, what totality is there? Finally, we are getting a lot of fruits, mean technologies, but at the grassroots, it is a technology. And technology can be configured, can be realized with the sensing, embedded and connectivity. For example, you want to have an agriculture related application, then you are having sensor related to agriculture, like pH value, temperature of a soil, moisture, right? Or other nitrogen, phosphorus, different kind of parameter you are making. If you are having a medical, then maybe ECG, right? EMG, blood pressure may be there, body temperature may be there. Similarly, for example, structure health, we may have pressure, we may have temperature, right? Similarly, for example, footstep detection, we may have ground sensor, we may have different kind of sensing modality like camera. So like that, according to the area, it will vary. And then embedded processing, and then finally the connectivity to the user. But also there is an important layer that is known as software layer. Because sometimes we are making a technique. Our technique is reliable detection algorithm. How much detection accuracy is there? How much processing time it is taking? Whether it is giving a false alarm or not? That is why it is differ. Another thing, how much time it is taking? Whether you are detecting early, for example, a small packet of signal you are taking, some technique is taking 2 seconds of data, some technique is taking 3 seconds of data. Another comes to the accuracy. What is the accuracy level you have achieved? Because if it will not be accurate, detection is a primary thing for any event to happen. And if it is detected wrong, then complete cycle will be wrong. And user will not have lost the faith in the technology. So that is why the first crucial thing to work upon the detection thing. And then application. You are aware of that smart health, smart card, smart tag, right? Smart lighting, smart grid, smart home. You know, smart tag nowadays, vehicle is moving. So automatically it is detecting on a barriers, right? So that is also smart parking is there, smart energy is there. So all these technologies are coming up with the smart city technologies. And it is only because of the IoT, different services, technologies, is connecting everyone. The means outreach to the society. So we discuss about IoT, we discuss about characteristics, we discuss about the IoT of the elements. Now the IoT is also like that, it is NEX. NEX means anything, any device. So talk about any device, talk about any technology, talk about any area. If we are able to connect it and rely the IoT based network, there is no restrictions. It cannot be like that we cannot apply to the agri related. It cannot be like that we cannot apply to the medical thing. It cannot be like that we cannot apply to the disaster one. It cannot be like that building. So it can be applied to anywhere. Anything, anyone and anybody. Anyone can be people. Anyone can be a critical installation. Anyone can be a, like, for example, metros, right? There can be any user we can talk about. It can be individual, it can be a group. Another thing is a service, business. Finally, we are providing a service or doing business. And any path, any network. Because when network are there, like, for example, if we are giving a call to the Chennai person, how our path has been established, right? So ultimate information should be reached with a reliable network. Any place, anywhere, because when we talk about this technology, it can be for the ground, it can be on the water, even it can be on the above the ground surface, like drone kind of application. So that should be there, any time, any context. So if we are talking about all these things, it is an Internet of Things. And why these things are being evolving, if you will see 2020, you see world population will be 7.6 billion and the connected device will be 50 billion. Now you can see a single person will have on average seven devices to be connected with one person. Now you can see if one person is having seven devices and that will be connected, how much bandwidth we require, right? How much security is a concern, how much technological solution we required, how many app we need to install, right? So we have to provide a lot of information, because still a lot of things has not been provided to the ordinary persons, whether in terms of health, whether in terms of a farmer technology, it is not outreach. So there are different kind of IoT also coming, like IoT of Internet of Anything, Internet of Everything, Secure IoT. So there are different, even nowadays medical information, Internet of Thing is also coming up. So the term is vehicle, Internet of Vehicles. So different area is connected with the IoT, is giving the different areas like medical IoT, vehicle IoT. So different kind of IoT's technologies are coming up. So if you will see the projected market share by the 2020, two important sector is very important, healthcare and manufacturing sector. Because in manufacturing sector, you know, industry 4.0, when things will be automated, we want to have a more yield from the industry. Because of the automation, it is possible to get more output from the industry. And another thing is healthcare, because we want a good health for everyone. Hospitals, telemedicine, right? Using the NKN, National Knowledge Network, right? You can see both are having 74% of the requirement. Next, you can see agriculture, security, urban infrastructures, electricity, they will contribute less. So the most market share will be in this area. And maximum, which we are expecting, is a good health for everyone. That is a healthcare sector. So we talked about Industry 4.0. So what is the Industry 4.0? It is the Internet of Services. All the devices, all the sensors are connected into a network. They are checking auto thresholding. Independently, they are deciding and then acting. And another thing is the analytics and cognition. Analytics and cognition is that the data is being processed, machine intelligence is incorporated, and automatically it is taking the decisions. And then flexible manufacturing, you are aware of that 3D rapid prototypings are coming up. So automatically flexibility is involved. Another thing is the Internet of Things. If all these things are connected to industry, it is giving an industrial revolution that is known as the Industry 4.0. And now another thing comes, what is a edge device? So now we are talking about the edge devices, edge computing. So you are aware of that we talked about the sensor network. So what is the philosophy of a sensor network? What it is doing? All the sensors are sensing a particular quantity of physical attribute and transferring the data to the center recording station. Now center recording station is deciding about the data, what to do. Now, in case of edge computing, we are talking about the computational technique available with the edge only, and this edge at the local node level. For example, if we are having a node for computing the pollution of a city, one thing is that all the data is transferred to the center recording station. Now we are talking about that each node which is installed in a particular sector is having inbuilt intelligence, processing the data. Now only the required information or processed data is being sent to the center recording. For example, you can see in this slide, there are different kind of edge devices are there, edge node are there. Edge node and simple node, difference is only that when we are saying edge mean where data is being taken, where data is being collected, the intelligence and computation part is lying there only. But in case of a wireless network, sensor network, we were having all the decision to be taken by the central recording station. Here, all the processing, all the computation, all the intelligence is available at the node level where field station is being installed. That is why it is having a lot of advantage. For example, if we are transferring data to the central recording station, now we are fully dependent upon the central recording station to take any important decision. But decision is required by the edge. So the technology is saying that you place all the processing, all the intelligence at edge level, only inform the action taken to the, so that load will be less. For example, if 10 node is connected to the center recording station, then all 10 is giving the raw data to the center recording station. Then the complete load is available on the center recording station. But in case of edge node, edge computing, the load is distributive. And therefore, reliability and also the processing capability will be increased. So edge computing is nothing but it is between the data and the final cloud. So it is just like a fog computing is also being said. So this is very important for intelligent system which we are processing the data. So you can see edge computing, there are different kind of edge servers are there, operational network are there, they are connected to a internet. Then finally data will be transferred to the center recording station. So what is the advantage we are having? For example, we discuss about the temperature of a plant. For example, a juice plant is there. And we are talking about if temperature is above 20 is an abnormal and there will be contamination of the complete system will be there. So what we were doing, we were transferring the information to the center recording station and then we are waiting for what action to be done. And suppose there is a lot of latency and the information has not been retrieved back, then the whole of the process will be wasted. Now in edge computing, what we are doing, we are taking the decision, shut down or stopping the wall or coolant, whatever may be the required, and informing only if I have done this work. Only log file is being given to the center recording station. Only the information that temperature was about that, and I have taken this information. I have taken this decision. So what is the positive thing in this technology is that reduced data transfer, because now we are not transferring the raw data. Now we are transferring only the required data, the process data. So hence there is a low latency, local feedback loop is there because more intelligent and decision is given to the local level. And privacy is also there, security is also there, because that is not available to all the thing. So that is why edge computing with machine learning, because machine intelligence algorithm is also available at the edge level, and advanced network capability is important along with the IoT. So in the edge computing, we are generating the data from the thing that can be wearable, car, building, meters, mobile device, and data is being sensed. Data is being collected, processed. What is the automatic we are doing? The thing we are doing, early data analytics. Previously, we were doing the data analytics. Now we are talking about the early data analytics because we are talking about the early warning systems. We are talking about the alert system. Early warning means there can be, say, this intruder case I discussed. So how fast and early we are deciding that intruder has taken place. Similarly, for example, in case of a disasters, if some disaster is happening before its wave reaches to a particular point and we are taking the decision. When we are talking about early, it means fast computation is required, fast processing is required. Therefore, we are not dependent on the central processing. We are dependent upon the edge level where each and an independent node is computing and processing only the information or parameter is given, so early decision can be taken up. So this is very, and deep data analytics mean deep neural network or the data will be stored into the cloud, but this will be the process one. And the edge you can see between the operational technology and information technology. So edge computing is very, very important when you are talking about the early analytics, early warning system, and very sophisticated data which is required for the critical installation. Therefore, your sophistication not in terms of a technology but also the component like hardware, software, interfaces, data storage, and also the other machine learning algorithm. So the benefits what we are getting because of the edge computing, you know, it is an improved performance. As we have taken an example, if the decision is taken at the edge level only, then we are not dependent upon overall network. And another thing, data privacy and security is also satisfied. because we are only sending the processed information. So data is lying with the node only, and which will also reduce the operational cost. And this operational cost, not only by the money wise, but also the computation wide processing time and other overheads. So there are different kinds of characteristics are there. For example, there are low latencies are there, cloud computing to the edge, widespread geographical distribution with the intelligence are there, and there will be heterogeneity of the connected of people, fog application. So we are saying a lot of network now can be connected because we are not processing at the center level. We are only retrieving information. For example, a pollution department can also take data from the meteorological department. That what was the temperature, what are the other thing, geographical survey, what is the soil condition. So like that, we are taking heterogeneity of the network can be connected because we are not processing the entire data. We are only taking the information, processed information. As we discuss, improve performance, compliance, privacy, security, reduce operational cost. So you can say performance mean alert and early data analytics, early warning. Right, compliance, privacy, secrecy, because we are talking about the crucial one, critical facility, so that person should not intrude into the network and can generate an alert, so that crash can be there, so that can be avoided. And operational cost we discussed about. So now it is clear ke why edge is required, because to decide at the local level, that the example we have taken, a pipe is there where the temperature is increasing, it may blast. Right, if we will wait from the center recording station to take appropriate action, because there can be a delay, there can be processing at this level. So we are highly dependent, although there is a problem at the node level because temperature has increased and the pump can be blast. So to avoid that situation, we are doing appropriate action at the edge level only, and then only informing to the center recording. That is the ultimate advantage of edge computing. So everything is, although now there is a disadvantage also. Disadvantage is that now it should be more rugged. Your hardware should be more reliable. Processing will be more at the edge level. But now advantage is that it is distributed in nature. So edge computing, there are different motivation, there are different challenges, there are different opportunities. Opportunities, you can understand there are n number of areas where it is required. Because early warning related to medical application, related to agro application, related to disaster application, related to strategic application, there are ample opportunities are there. Challenges are there because you are aware of that machine intelligence, rugged algorithm, hardware, all these things need to be placed at a particular point. And motivation is that there are different kind of decentralized thing is there because the decision will be taken at the edge level only, energy consumption, light limitation for the front end devices, because it's not like that. Okay, because we are processing here, so we have to optimize. We have to make a primary secondary level. Like for example, in morning we discussed okay, when intruder is trying to enter into a building. So we discuss about camera and discuss about the ground sensor. So ground sensor will be the primary one and another sensor will be the secondary one. So we are not processing all at a time. We have made in arrangement primary and secondary kind of thing. So that is also, and smart computational technique is available at the edge level. So there are different kind of motivation, different kind of challenges, different kind of opportunities we are having. So finally, you can see it is a layer between your device and into your cloud, because now data is not directly going to the cloud. There is a layer of a edge or fog where you are deciding. You are processing, you are deciding which data to be stored for the other user. So there is all the control, central control is avoided. So this is also the, you can see the difference between edge and fog. If fog is there, key, there are a lot of application is connected to the fog and then available to the cloud. So directly cloud is not coming into the picture. So if cloud and edge, we are, if we discuss what is the difference, because sometimes the term people are talking about, okay, they seems to be similar and there is an overlapping are there. Cloud mean it is off the premises, edge mean it is on the premises. at the level only where it is being installed. Cloud is a limited control, but edge is having a full control because you are developing the app, you are developing application, what kind of data to be processed, how to process, what intelligent technique is to be taken care. Similarly, there is a in cloud virtually unlimited resources, but in edge there are limited resources because we have to perform by one node only, process fast, so it is not like that unlimited things are available. Cloud easily scale, edge mean limited scale because of the processing power, because of the computation power available at the load level. But in terms of a privacy, in cloud there is a limited privacy, but in case of a edge there is a full privacy, because even to whom it can be a cryptography technique, we can encapsulate into the that level. So finally, what we are doing, there are n number of devices are there, they are doing a n number of attributes we are generating, raw data is being given, at the fog level we are deciding, then finally the virtualized data or machine learning predictive analysis or what kind of attribute to be stored on the cloud is being reduced. You can see at edge level huge amount of data is being produced, but at the cloud only the limited processed one is also available for the other user. This is also an extra advantage to other users. So if you will talk about edge computing, cloud computing, centralized like email, videos, hosted application, smart city, machine to machine, healthcare is an advanced one which is now coming up. And you can see the frequency of data transfer versus the sensitivity of data transaction. And another thing is that we have talked about the data analytics. Now we are talking about the edge analytics. Edge analytics is nothing but all the processing for data and machine learning at the edge level. And IoT based, there are sensing layer, there are processing layer, and finally it is connected to the internet, right? So for example, if we want to have a campus is there, take a big campus of a 1 by 1 kilometer, and you are saying it's a no man's land, right? Because of the critical installation. And now there can be n number of network scattered around, right? And they are deciding about the occurrence of an event and then informing to the center that I have detected its presence and processed it with the machine intelligence. So this is a very important technology as compared to all the array of a network is giving data to the center recording station. So one huge case study where we have worked and we have designed a IoT based network, I want to tell. There is an earthquake warning system which we have designed and we have installed is to the Delhi Metro. Delhi, we have complete fence with our network. This is the technology designed by us. And it is a node intelligence edge network. And also it is connected to the IoT. You will see Mundka, Metro Bhavan, Faridabad, Huda City, Botanical Garden. We have fenced the network with the sensor nodes around the Delhi. If you see, Delhi is having four corner and middle one. Earthquake can come from the UP side, earthquake can come from the Hindu Kush side, it can also come from the Hansi side. So what we have done, we have placed our sensor that way from wherever it will come, it will be detected by our network first. So whenever any event will come, then it will be detected and then it will be processed and a warning will be generated. And this warning, because in case of an earthquake, there is a philosophy is there. There are two waves are there. One is a P wave, another is a S wave. P wave travel at the rate of 6 km/s, but they travel along the axis. Because of that, they travel along the axis. They are not a disaster in nature. But the S wave, they travel 4 km/s and they travel perpendicular to the axis. Therefore, they are disaster in nature. Because of their difference in velocity, the indicator waves come much early, travel at the rate of 6 km/s, right? So we can have an advantage of lead time, but that lead time will not be more than few seconds, tens of a seconds. So everything need to be automatic because it's a few seconds of our alarm is there. people may ask, okay, why there is a few seconds of alarm? You are aware of that. If I am giving you 30 seconds, if this building is going to collapse, within 30 seconds, you may be out. Another thing, for example, some critical facilities like refineries are there, like nuclear plant production are there, right? Some gas bottling plants are there. High-speed train is moving. They may be slowed down. Flight takeoff and landing can be controlled. In hospital, some emergency lighting can be restored for operation. So that time is also very important to save the life. If the technology, if we are able to save one people life, then also it is a good technology. But the important crucial thing is there, that there should not be false alarm. Otherwise, people will not be able to take that appropriate decision, because the lead time is only few seconds, tenths of the second. And this is the waves you can see. One is a traveling perpendicular to the axis, top one. Another, you can see the perpendicular to the axis, S wave. And their velocity difference is there. Now, what we are going to do, we are trying to give a Sysmo edge. That is edge computing. Previous network, you have seen this network where all the data was transferred to the center recording. This is a simple network of a network system. Now we are talking about the edge computing, where each and every system will have an inbuilt intelligence, will also classify between noise and event, will also have an ability to detect different kinds of wave, so that we may not be dependent upon the entire network. Because why this is not required? Because take care of a mall, big mall, like in Chandigarh, Dalante Mall. So why they will have a network in the city? They want to install system at their own premises. Right, when we are installing system at one particular site, previously we are deciding on the basis of n network, n node. Now we are deciding on the basis of single one. So when we are talking about single one, it means it should have be more intelligence, and it is taking decision itself. So it should be edge computing based. All the algorithm, all the machine intelligence should be at this level only. So this is the difference, which is the between normal computing when we are talking about a network, and this is the thing which we are having an edge computing, where all the intelligence and decision is being taken. But both the technology is connected to the user, because previous technology, you can see when the report is being generated, the things is being automated, things is being detected, it is being given to the user, because ultimately the information given to the registered user. Similarly, in this case also, the information will be given to the registered user through SMS, through email, whatever be the appropriate to the users. So when we talk about edge computing, now you can see there will be a machine learning here. When machine learning here will be, so previously there was no decision. It was only detecting and then sending the data to the center one, and it is deciding what to do. Now the all the attributes, all the machine learning attribute is to be incorporated into the node only, and this node is now intelligent one. Therefore, its ruggedness in terms of a hardware, its software, because time is very less. If you will see around the world, people are doing a lot of work for the reducing the lead time in how much warning you are giving to the user, and improving the performance by ensuring that there will not be a false alarm. So people are doing this thing around the world. So I can say, okay, we discuss about edge computing, we discuss about IoT. IoT is beyond our imagination, because we are saying anywhere, anything, any time. So it can be connected to the any area, whatever in your mind. So finally, you can see okay, IoT is beyond our imagination, means even there are a lot of things to go with the computation level, with the edge computation level, and lot of things to go with other level, other processing level, machine intelligence level, and even with a small embedded intelligence in a field level that is required. So this is all about our first thing, first part of the lecture, which is edge computing and IoT.